another team, Renegade. An unbeaten average MMA record of 1 win and no losses, ladies and gentlemen. Let's welcome Matt Hammerhead Howard. And his opponent is the record for another intensity MMA. Also making their amateur MMA debut this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let's welcome Aiden Moore.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Golden Ticket Fight Promotions 21 right here in Wolverhampton. We're on fight 7 of the night. £145 featherweight matchup in the blue corner in the grey shorts. We've got Matt Howarth fighting out of Team Renegade. In the red corner, making his amateur debut, we've got Aiden Marsh in the black shorts. He's a bit of a local rivalry, actually, between Intensity MMA in the Black Country and Team Renegade in Birmingham. Matt used his strength there just to shrug off the takedown attempt and look for a single leg of his own as Aiden Marsh defends up against the fence. I have to say, what a fantastic contrast in walkout songs as well. We had Matt Howarth walking out to a Christmas song and then Aiden Marsh to death metal. That's what mixed martial arts is all about. Matt there just perhaps looking to lock on the choke there, but drops down for the single leg. Nice job defending there from Aiden, who lands a knee up the middle.
Looked like it hurt him. He dropped his hips in quick then.
Aiden, of course, making his amateur debut. Matt is currently 1-0. You've got to see the game plan here from Matt straight away. He's looking to get this fight to the Matt. He obviously feels that that's where he's going to be more comfortable.
Oh, yeah.
But Aiden's doing a really good job so far to defend these takedowns, and as you've just seen, reverse the position. But once again,
considering Aiden's debut and he showed about 4 or 5 punches, it must be Matt's game plan to wrestle and get it to the floor.
Yeah, Aiden nearly defended that takedown again there, but he's in danger of giving up his back here to Aiden. Matt, he's about to take the back of Aiden here, sorry. He's got the one.
He's got the choke in. He's got the choke in. It's deep.
Yeah, it's underneath the chin there. He's got the underneath the neck, so he's got to be careful.
Looking for the short choke. Oh no, it's gone. It's lost it. Flatten him out though. He's got the hooks in.
Yeah, he's deciding just to.
They're all on the ground.
I'll just smash these right hands into your face instead and see how that goes. Yeah, just look to flatten him out again there, but it's a nasty position for Aiden Marsh to be in early on in this first round.
It's a hard position as well, because transitioning out of a turtled position, like, you're almost more protected to be in a turtle, but then if you don't do anything, you can't really do nothing from turtle. But if you don't do anything, you're going to get stopped by the referee.
Absolutely, and this is a really dangerous position. She's got that left hand tied up as well there of Aiden.
Yeah, he's got the Dagestan handcuff.
Yeah, this is horrible to try and defend, but I mean, Aiden doesn't seem particularly fazed. He's trying to remain calm, but until he releases that hand, it's going to be really difficult for him to get out of this position.
Yeah. I mean, Matt's doing a lot of work. Aiden's game plan could be just keep a bit squirmy, tired Matt out, because wrestling's a hard game. I'm impressed by Aiden's hair.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Oh, trusting to do.
Looking for the armbar there, but he's not going to get that.
Do you know what? Considering this is the debut, this is really good.
He looks very calm and composed in there,
yeah,
doesn't he? I mean,
really, really good.
Credit there to Dan Cassell and Steve Langford and the rest of the guys at Intensity MMA. They've got their debuting fighter well trained, but you certainly have to think that first round went to Matt Howarth, who took the back of his opponent and landed some heavy shots. I mean, once he got that fight to the mat, he didn't look particularly interested in, obviously we saw that attempted kind of short choke, but after that he seemed to just be quite happy just landing those heavy ground and pound shots. As you say, really impressive from Aiden Marsh that he was able to kind of just ride the position, especially when Matt had that Dagestani handcuff.
Yep.
I mean, a lot of fighters on their debuts would panic in that situation and kind of give up the rear naked choke, but absolutely not. 100% composure at all times from Aiden Marsh.
Aiden doesn't look too tired as well. Neither of them do, to be honest.
He's giving us a little smile and a nod here in the commentary booth. I think he's enjoying his debut here.
I think with your debut, there's often two ways it can go. You either have no idea what's going on, so you're just enjoying for what it is, or you're nervous as shit.
Which were you on yours?
I honestly had no nerves at all. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know how I was going to handle it. It was my second fight.
Beautiful
head kick. Whipped it straight up as well.
Yeah, Matt Gardner just looked in there as if to say, what are you doing? Shot straight in for the single leg. Don't think he enjoyed eating that shot. But beautiful scramble again from these two guys.
I'd be surprised if this guy hasn't got a background in wrestling or something. His scrambles are actually
really
decent. He needs to get a better wizard here and try and get up onto his elbow. Matt hasn't got his wrist, so he needs to use the cage if he can to sort of wall walk up.
Heavy ground and pound.
Heavy ground and pound.
Left hand here with Matt. He's using his head there as kind of just to keep the position.
He needs to like window wipe his hand on the wrist to control that wrist to keep it away from him.
Nice shot there from Matt, who's transitioned into the full mount and he's landing the ground and pound.
Yeah, you can use this cage to help buck him off. Use the cage to walk up the cage and then sort of buck this guy off. That would be a one option. He can't stay flat on his back though. He's got to do some movement, otherwise he's going to get finished here.
Yeah,
some heavy shots.
Dan Overhead, he's taking a big look at this. And I mean, striking back from the bottom is not really
the
answer.
Not at all.
You want to get out of this.
You need to move. He's trying to use his dexterity, but it's not working.
I mean, a lot of these are landing on the hands and stuff. I mean,
yeah, a lot of that was landed on.
Yeah.
This.
He's got to advance the position, and there's the stoppage victory for Matt Howard. I mean, he was just absolutely relentless when he got into that top position.
Sure.
I mean, you've got to feel for Aidan Marsh, because like we say, a lot of those were kind of landing on the gloves and the forearms, but obviously, fighter safety, especially amateurs, is first and foremost. A few of those did sneak through, but
you got to think when you hit him with the hammer fist, it's not, there's no protection here. It's all here, and from up to down is a solid shot.
And Matt did a really good job when he got into that format position. I mean, he kind of stayed heavy and
he was high off the hips as well. So like, if he was a bit lower on the hips, Aidan would be able to buck and then off balance him to create some space. But unfortunately, Matt just kept his hands up. He wasn't trying to keep Aidan down on the hips. But that's the way of the game.
Absolutely. I mean, Aidan doesn't look very happy. He's taking his gloves off and throwing his gloves down. I don't know whether that means he's calling it out one fight, whether he's just disappointed with the outcome and the result. But I mean, we certainly saw some skills from Aidan Marsh, and I'd be really interested in seeing him fight again. I mean, he was. Definitely on in those scramble exchanges, well, he definitely held his own for a lot of them. It's just the fact that Matt had that slightly better skill advantage and an experience advantage. But we're going to hand this one over now to our MC in the cage to make this one official as Matt Howarth moves to 2-0 as an amateur.
Peace out.